In this video, I'm going to be going over the most popular 4K export settings for YouTube or final delivery. I'm going to be going over two methods, the H.264 method and the H.265 method. So if you've been curious of like the best 4K export settings, I'm going to be covering everything in this video. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So to get started, I'm inside Premiere Pro, and the first thing that you want to check is your sequence settings. Just go up to sequence settings. Make sure that you're in a 4K sequence setting. Make sure your frame rate is correct in the display and the time base, and that everything looks okay. I'm going to click OK, and the first thing that we want to do before we export our sequence is create our in and out points. So make sure your playhead is at the very beginning of your sequence. Click I on your keyboard to set an in point, and then navigate to the end of your sequence. Make sure you're on your last shot. Click the down button, and then click O on your keyboard. This will create an out point. That way, only this section will be exported. Okay, now that we have our selection, we can go to Export. We can go up to the Export tab in the top left. You can also go to File, Export, Media as well to get there. Okay, so the first thing that you want to adjust in here is just make sure that the media file switch is on. As you can see, it's blue in the top left. That means it's activated. And then the other thing to check is your range. If you click on the dropdown, you can change it from entire source to source in and out. That way it's reading our in and out markers that we just selected in our timeline. All right, so the next part is to name our final video. So you can click in the file name box. I'm gonna rename this final video. And then next to location, we can choose where to locate it. So I'm gonna export it to my desktop since that's where I usually like to save my final videos. Just make sure it's somewhere that you can locate it later. And now we get into the fun stuff. So for format, first I'm gonna go over the H.264 codec, and then later in this video, feel free to skip ahead if you want to look at H.265. So really the $1 million question when it comes to exporting 4K video clips or final videos is whether to use H.264 or H.265, and what is really the big difference? Essentially, when it comes to H.264, it's the most universal file video codec. So this is supported by YouTube. Most computers can play it back. H.264 is the most universal file format when it comes to final video files. H.265, on the other hand, high efficiency video codec, is a more efficient and new way to compress large video files. So this is popular when it comes to 4K, 8K clips. You can expect lower file sizes. So if you're experiencing, you know, exporting 4K videos and you want to decrease the file size, this is a good codec that you can use to decrease the file size. But the caveat when it comes to H.265 video codecs is not a lot of media players can play them back correctly. You might need like VLC player, a certain player to read the actual H.265 codec. YouTube recommends still H.264. That's why I'm going to cover H.264 first when it comes to 4K. So it really depends on where your final video is going to go. If your computer or the playback system can read H.265 or not. But in the end, H.265, the real difference is you can expect smaller file sizes and it more efficiently compresses the data for large file formats. Now let's take a look at H.264 and the best 4K settings for that codec specifically. All right, so once H.264 is selected here from the dropdown, I'm gonna change the preset. I recommend first changing it, if we scroll down, to match source adaptive high bitrate. And what this will essentially do, it'll match your source sequence settings, and it will automatically choose the best bitrate settings for your video based on the footage in your own timeline. So when we click that, you'll see that it changes down below. You can see that it just matches the source. So essentially, we don't really need to adjust these, but if you ever do, you can always uncheck the boxes and make adjustments. You can go down to custom and whatnot and change the settings for whether it's the frame size or the frame rate. I'm gonna undo that though. I'm gonna leave everything checked on here. Now, if we scroll down, two things I do recommend turning on, and this really depends on your own video project. This may or may not have an impact, but it's better to turn these on. But you can check the box next to render at maximum depth. This is for footage with a high color bit depth, and then use maximum render quality. Use maximum render quality is essentially if you are editing maybe 12K, 8K clips in a 4K timeline, this will most efficiently compress and size it down. Or maybe you're exporting it in 1080 or a different resolution, this will just maintain the maximum render quality. Now, if we scroll down, some important video encoding settings to change. I recommend changing it to hardware encoding. Hardware encoding uses the GPU, your computer's GPU, where software just relies on the CPU, it'll be much slower of an export setting. You may not see hardware encoding if your computer's GPU isn't compatible with your export settings, so it will default to software if it's not available here. Now for profile, I recommend unchecking it and changing it to high. High for the profiles for HD footage and up. Main is for standard definition. When it comes to this, the H.264 setting specifically. Now, if we scroll down, we can go down to the bitrate settings. So when it comes to bitrate, there's two different options, CBR and VBR. CBR stands for constant bitrate, VBR stands for variable bitrate. And what bitrate is, really quickly, it's basically how much metadata is in each frame of video when it exports. So essentially, reading this right now, it's gonna preserve 60.7 megabits in each second of video. If you click and drag the slider up, it's going to dedicate more bits per second in your video clip, and all the way down, it's going to dedicate less. And if you'll notice, if you leave it all the way down and export it out, it'll be very blocky, very pixelated. It doesn't have a lot of data in the final video, where if you turn it up, you'll notice that it's very crisp, it's very clean. But you don't want to go too high because, you know, cameras can only record at a certain limit, so I don't recommend changing it up all the way. I recommend choosing a pretty happy medium between low and high. And if we are following YouTube's recommended upload settings, I'll link this down in the video description if you want to see this. If we go down to bitrate, we can see based on our footage here that for 4K at 30 frames or 24 frames a second, which is the sequence setting I have, it recommends between 35 to 45 megabits per second. And if you're in a high frame rate, it recommends just a little bit more, between 53 and 68. So if we go back over here, we can change this to 40, a nice happy medium there. And then when it comes to CBR and VBR, VBR essentially dedicates more bits per second in different areas of your screen. So for example, if it's a very complicated scene, this isn't, but say if we go out forward a little bit, this is a little bit more complicated because there's more shadows, there's more light, we have a light leak. It's going to dedicate more bits per second in this frame rather than the silhouette photo of maybe just that. Where CBR, if we change it to CBR, it's gonna maintain 40 megabits per second regardless if it's a complex scene or not, whether it's a black screen or it's a complicated shot. It's gonna dedicate 40 megabits per second for every single second in your final exported video. For YouTube, I recommend VBR One Pass. It is actually what they recommend on their own website here. If we go up to video codec, you can see variable bitrate right there. No bitrate limit is required, though we offer recommended bitrates below, as we just covered. So variable bitrate. And when it comes to one pass, two pass, one pass basically export it once out of Premiere Pro, and two pass will export it once and then do a second pass to check the accuracy. The big thing with checking two pass is that you'll notice that it will change the encoding settings to software encoding. So I recommend just leaving on one pass because I personally don't really see that much of a difference. So I always recommend VBR one pass, 40 megabits per second for 4K exported video clips for YouTube. The last thing I would check is audio. Make sure that you're using the AAC audio format. And then for the bitrate of that, they recommend 384. So I'm just gonna change it to that. Obviously, I didn't have any audio for this, but if you do have audio, you can always check this on, make sure that these settings match. You can always check the audio format over here. Audio codec recommends the sample rate, either 96 kilohertz or 48 kilohertz, and either stereo, stereo plus 5.1. And if we scroll down to the bottom of the bitrate section, it says for stereo that they want 384 kilobits per second. All right, so back in Premiere Pro, that's pretty much it. All these other tabs I don't really mess with. And once you're ready, you can click this export button in the bottom right-hand corner, and this will export out your video. Okay, so that's the H.264 4K export settings. Let's take a look at H.265 and how some of the settings differ. All right, so if we go back up to the top here, say if you wanted to export an H.265, you would choose the HEVC, High Efficiency Video Codec, format, and then down below in video, this is the first area I recommend going into. We'll check down below. I recommend clicking on match source. This will just match the source of your actual sequence setting. You can see right now it's trying to export it out as an 8K clip, but if we click match source, it'll just match it to my sequence setting. And if you wanna see down right here underneath source in and out, this is your actual source sequence settings. So you can always check this to make sure that it's exporting it in the correct sequence settings. So all this should remain the same. Same thing here, I do recommend checking the box next to render at maximum depth if you do a lot of color grading or work with 10-bit color and also use maximum render quality. That'll just make sure that you're exporting in the best quality possible here. Now, if we scroll down, the encoding settings look a little bit different here. For profile, you only have main, and main 10. Main 10 is for HDR footage. So I recommend 99% of the time just stick with main. We aren't talking about HDR today if you're into HDR export settings. But if you want to learn about HDR, let me know. I can make a video about it. For the level, I'm going to leave it at 6.2. In the tier, I will set to high. And then if we scroll down to bitrate, the biggest difference here is that it doesn't need to be as high. If you remember in my explanation of bitrate earlier, or the difference between H.264 and H.265, it more efficiently compresses the video, making smaller file sizes. So what I recommend for bitrate when it comes to H.265 is change it to HBR one pass. And then for the bitrate, I would recommend making it 35% less than what you did for H.264. So if you remember, we did 40 megabits per second for H.264, so 35% less than 40 is 26, and this will result in a lower file size. As you can see in the estimated file size, we're now at 116 megabytes. And that's pretty much it. The only other thing is go down to audio and then just change that bitrate back to the other 384, and then you should be good to go. You can click an export and export out your video. So that's how you export a 4K sequence out of Premiere Pro. If you have any questions at all, leave them down below. Also, if you want to learn more about export settings and kind of like the science that goes behind all these formats, how to set up your sequence settings, if you're experiencing choppy playback, all the nooks and crannies that you need to know as a video editor, I will link a live stream that I did last year that really goes in depth. I think it has a lot of value in it. I'll link it right up there if you do want to check that out. Feel free to earmark that, and when you have time, watch that. I think it's full of value. But otherwise, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.